What's up, YouTube? I want to just do a video today. It's Sunday. And I'm going to show everyone how I get down with this pork shoulder roast. So basically, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna show everyone how I pretty much do a pork roast, a big piece of meat like this. It's kind of the way my mom taught me how to do it, you know. I really love the flavor that this method brings to the meat. So you're just gonna take an onion and a bell pepper. And no special cut, nothing special this time. I'm gonna blend. Chop it all up. So, you might just cut it in smaller pieces. Just like that, you see what I got here. Dull knife. Oh man, get you some good knives. Thing should have been thrown away a long time ago. So, one whole bell pepper. I'm gonna try to put it all in there, save some time. Pepper always kind of gets juicy. Say, got bell pepper here. Oh, it smells good. Love bell peppers. Bell pepper stops cancer and all kind of bad stuff that goes on in your body. And people should eat a lot more of this. Green, dark green vegetables. Cutting it up like that, boom. I'm gonna go fast because this is kind of boring. So I'm gonna pause the video to save some time here. Okay, this is what I originally used, and there would also be some parsley, garlic, onions, and bell pepper in this mixture. But I'm just gonna do what I, working with what I got in here. I don't feel like going to the store. It's super hot outside. Another thing that I wanna try, I've never done this before, but I'm gonna put some muskrats in this mixture too. That looks weird, but I believe it's gonna give a flavor that I like. And so I'm gonna just blend some muskrats in here too. Thank you. because they're really leafy, I'm gonna actually put some of this back in there to help it. That brought it down for me. Yeah, I need to get that. I know that's gonna cook real good. Ooh, I taste it right now. Okay. Mustard greens. Wow, you ain't never. I have some other crazy ideas. Whoa, not crazy, but. That I want to show you, I'm gonna show y'all this new idea I have on vegetables. Okay, with these them big sticks, you done that. Yeah, this doubles my mixture too. Because I didn't really have that much onion and bell pepper to start with. Making a little mess here. The counter's clean. Trust me, I sterilize my counters and everything before I start cooking in the kitchen. I clean up my entire kitchen. I cook with that way. I had a couple of friends. They clean, make us lunch in a filthy kitchen. Dirty dishes all in the sink. Grab me a cup out the sink and we'll just rinse it out. That mixture there. This smells amazing. Never done I've never done this like this before. Huge piece of meat. Look at that big piece of meat there. How you cook it? How you get flavor deep inside of it? You can inject it. That's a way with just like liquid and stuff, but I don't know. I think it's just the meat pushes all of that out anyway. Unless you really poke the hell out of it. This way is going to ensure that the flavor stays up in there. And you'll even get to taste that. But mama. Okay, this is the bone right there. You know, if I stab it in this way, I will hit the bone. So I'm gonna make cuts into the meat right here, all the way. And I hit a bone too still, but just like that, see? And I press my finger deep in it, in that hole. Put your finger in it, deep in there. That's fat. Yeah, look at that. That's something else when you get your meat. Let's cut that off. Or, you know what? I might not. I See, this knife is dull. It's gonna make me work harder, and I could potentially cut myself here. But that's why you wanna have a sharp knife. But I'm gonna get this fat off of here. I cannot have that in there. It's a big piece of fat. That's what you pay for. You know, when you buy cuts of meat like this. This is all of the farmer's money, all of the feed he gave to this pig to fatten him up, fatten it up before they make a butt roast out of him. Wow, man. But this is the main part of the video anyway. I don't edit too much, so I don't have the stuff to do all of that. You might get a pause here and there, but that's about all I could do. So I got most of this off of me, because that's where it would have been. On me. You know if that's meat or not, you might want to fry that up for breakfast. Right. Anyway, shut. Got the holes there. Let's make some more incisions here. Oh, that's really, really tough right there. I butterflied it inside there, made it like a cavern. I went to the left and to the right over there, cutting it. That'll be a nice big hole. Now, this has got to be seasoned. This is all good and everything here, but unless it's seasoned well, it's not gonna work. It'll taste like grass. Okay? If you don't season this part well, it will taste like grass. So, take the meat and we just start taking our stuffing and pushing it right inside there like that. See? Ooh, I put a little ball on the hole and just press it in there with my fingers. Then I'll go all the way in with my finger like that. See? In this hole too, every hole we made a slit. We're gonna shove these ingredients in there. Preheat the oven. I preheated mine to 350. This is gonna cook a really long time, a couple of hours, just up there. Get all of these flavors in there. All of this is gonna cook really nice. And when you cut into this meat and you see all of these beautiful spices, and there's no herbs in this one, but you would see the herbs as you cut into the meat. And oh man, that's so good. That stuff is so good. You just mix that in with your rice or something. Talk about good. Now, I done added so much flavor to this piece of meat that really would be impossible to get flavor deep inside of it, cooking it. Just gotta remember where I put these holes at. And anything on the outside, but nothing. I'm gonna make it all fit. You thought it wasn't gonna fit. That don't even look like it. It was a hole I made. That's just a natural hole right there. I'm gonna stick something in it. If you have any cuts on your fingers, oh, this is going to sting. I don't have any of mine, but I have done this before, and it stung. It's like a antibacterial. Okay, so I got holes in there. Bam. If I feel for all of my holes, I'm gonna stuff every. I'll even make some more if I have to. Okay, so this is how I do my pork roast. I really enjoy this method. It brings a super amount of flavor into the meat that you normally would not be able to get in there. And when it's all done, I guess I'll show you as I pull it out and everything. Okay, now. This is the roasting pan. I love this pan. I've had this pan for over 15 years. It's my mom's, and it's just a roasting pan. And it's gonna take this pork roast. Look at how big it is. But you know what? That don't matter. I'm gonna take all of this good stuff here. Put that on there too. That's just gonna turn into a gravy at the bottom. And all of this, just is this also keep it nice and moist. I'm thinking that, you know, this mustard greens are going to release a bunch of water too into the pot roast itself, and it's going to be super juicy. Water to the bottom. Make sure it gets on both sides. There might be some blockage in there. Just want to move it around a little bit and make sure water gets over there. Okay. That water in here, there. Pop the lid in there. And into the oven it goes. I had the oven at 325, but I'm gonna bring it to 375 and let that cook for about 2 hours or more, because sometimes I just want it to be so super tender and stuff and just fall all apart. Okay. Taste it now. Okay, so that's how I get down with the pork roast. That was a method that I always use when I have a really huge piece of meat that needs flavor inside of it. And I'll show you when I pull it out the oven. Okay, what's up? Back again. I'm about to take it out the oven. It's been about, I think, over 3 hours. When I'm cooking pork, you know, especially a section of meat like this, you know, I have to overcook it. So it's so tender and falling off. I mean, I'm not gonna eat pork like they do lamb or other protein like beef and stuff. So, and I overcook it. Cause pork is not a clean animal at all. But this is it, here it goes. Let's see what it looks like. Okay, there you go. Oh, it's bubbling up in there. Wow, looks good. Super hungry. There wasn't that much water in there. Look, the water that came all up. Where that water comes from, didn't put that much. And then we got this. This looks super good. I'm just gonna knock that off. And you can see that the pork is cooked. It's pulling away from this big bone right here. Careful, this is piping hot. I wish I had a baster. This is when I put the spoon in, I do this to tell, you know, how much oil fat is on top of it. It's not that much fat. Taking that piece of fat off of there really helps. I see fat on top, but it's not as much. It's really cooked out. And we'll try it, please. Ooh. Man, that looks good. That is ready. Right, so that's how it looks. And that's how I did down with the pork roast. There's no red potatoes or anything up in there, but that's all I need right there. Right there, bam. Alright, thank you guys for watching. I really enjoy doing this sometimes, you know, when I have time. It's fun, I love cooking. And it's time to invite some friends over. So we'll have some to get out. I got the meat out. I managed to get it out of the roasting pan. It's time to work on a gravy, I see here. Okay, so that's the meat. It's falling apart too. This right here, this liquid, I'm going to like put this on a stove and like reduce it a little bit to have a nice gravy, because it's kind of watery. So that's what I'll do, is just a little bit, you know, help. I don't know, like maybe it'll bring out the even more depth of flavor when you reduce it a little bit more. And that's what I'm gonna do. Can I do this? So you can see me cut into this. Watch your. You can kind of see the first parts of that where the seasoning and everything is inside of the pork roast is falling apart. I just want you to see, oh, this looks amazing. It smells amazing too. So that was a nice big piece. You can see that that's what you'll be getting, that just like that. Delicious pork. Okay, you got the sauce right there. Nice fluffy rice. Really nice charro, amazing charro beans. Save it for the food that I don't have ever seen, the food that I ever seen. Do you send it to Jesus' name? Amen. Delicious pork is tender, you know. You get it out there with a spoon. Get some of that good green stuff. Now, this is my first time, let me see. It worked out perfect. I wish I cut a piece with more of that in it. Damn, that's really good. The green stuffing inside there is just amazing. Mm-hmm.